Hello, I'm going to go through exercise 11, excuse me, 11-4 from the homework number 2. So what's going on here is we've been given the stockholders' equity section of Culver Co Corporation's balance sheet as of December 31st. We've been given some information about the different types of stock that they have issued, and then we are asked some questions about these. The first question is, how many shares of common stock are outstanding? So if we look up here at our common stock, we can see that 579,000 shares have been issued. And also, if you look down here, we have treasury stock of 5,700 common shares. To calculate how many outstanding shares we have, we just take the total shares issued less the common shares in treasury stock, which gives us 573,300 shares outstanding. The next question, it says, assume there is a stated value. What is the stated value of the common stock? So again, we'll look at our common stock here, and as I said, we have 579,000 shares issued. There is no paid in capital and excess of stated value account on here, so we can assume that all of these shares were sold for their stated value. So to calculate this, I would take the value of the common stock and divide it by the number of outstanding, or not outstanding shares, but shares issued. And that would give us $3 per share as the stated value. The third question here is, what is the par value of the preferred stock? So we'll look at our preferred stock here. And again, to find out the par value, we would take, again, since there's no paid in capital in excess of stated value account for the preferred stock, we're going to assume that the 6,900 shares issued were sold for their par value. So we'll take the amount, the value of the preferred stock, and divide it by the value or the number of issued shares, and that gives us a par value of $100 per share. Now, the fourth question, if the annual dividend on preferred stock is 48,300, what is the dividend rate on preferred stock? To calculate this, I would take the 48,300 and divide it by the number of preferred stock issued, which is 6,900, and that gives us a value of $7 per share, and the shares, as we found, their par value is $100. That gives us, so we would take 7 divided by 100, and we get 7%. So our dividend rate on preferred stock is 7%. The last question here is, if dividends of $71,100 were in arrears on preferred stock, what would be the balance reported for retained earnings? Now, I'm not sh totally sure about this. Hopefully, I guess we'll find out when I press submit the answer. But what I understand is that unless dividends have been formally declared by the board of directors, they are not considered a liability to the corporation and therefore are not on the books anywhere. So since it doesn't say that these arrears have been declared, I would assume that the retained earnings amount does not change from what is stated up here. So that would be $1,192,000. Guess we'll see if we get that one right. So I'll just submit these answers and see how that went. And I guess I was right about that. So, all right, thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, let me know.